Those of you who follow me on Instagram know that we are in Leh right now. Welcome to Tarot Pal if you just found me on a YouTube search. Today we're doing an important impromptu read. I was really, really guided to make this. So the message that has come in today are, you know, I'm pretty surprised at how in sync they are also to each other. So you might get pulled to more than one pile, which is absolutely fine. What is the theme? You've already seen it in the thumbnail. What are the urgent, important messages for you? This message is meant to find you. While, of course, this is a general reading, it cannot resonate with everybody. Take what resonates and leave the rest. If you have just found me on YouTube, we are new to YouTube and we are growing every day. So don't forget to subscribe if the readings resonate. Don't forget to watch the September monthly reading already uploaded. And the other timeless readings are also in the description box below. Donations are never expected, always received with gratitude. So if you find resonance, if you find help in any of the readings that you have seen with Tarot Pal, there is a number given on which you can don't call or WhatsApp, but you can do a Paytm or a UPI transfer. Again, never expected, always appreciated. This is, of course, a free platform. I hope you find value with every reading that you see. If you want a paid personal reading, you can head to my Instagram. You will find the details there or drop me an email. All of that detail is mentioned below. I am soon going to show up with crystals for you guys as well. So I'm excited for that. About a 30 days timeline is what I've given myself to launch it. I hope you like the readings. You will find all the information in the description box below. Don't forget to subscribe because that means the world to me. Take care. Hi Tarot Pals. This is pretty impromptu. If you're following me on Instagram, I know this was not on the plan, but I got to listen to what the spirit says. If you just found me through some algorithm search on YouTube, welcome to Tarot Pal. We're a new and everyday growing family. All my readings are timeless. You will find playlist and you will find recommended reads in the description box below. If the reading resonates, please don't forget to subscribe. We are looking at what urgent messages does Spirit want to give you. If there's any additional guidance, this is more tarot centric, but I do have a fortune cookie for you and an angel guidance card. Okay, so without much ado, you will find all the details in the description box. I'm not going into that. Follow me on Instagram for daily rituals and more fun live readings. Now I have three options for you. The first option is smoky quartz. Okay. Option number two is blue lace agate. And option number three is amethyst. You can pause the video. You can choose more than one pile if you're drawn to more than one pile. And I will see you in your pile. So those of you who's picked the beautiful smoky quartz. First things first, Spirit wants to acknowledge the pain and the suffering that you've been through. They see you, they feel you, they've been through with it. I do see many of you have gone through emotional, financial, real betrayals, heartbreaks, disappointment, things not working out for you. You know, some not so great people surrounded. Maybe perhaps this has already happened for most of you. I feel for most of you, this is already done. Some of you are currently going through this energy where you don't have a lot of supportive people to reach out to and lean on, and you're still in that heartbreak. Okay, if you are here, then let me tell you what lies ahead is definitely, definitely better. If I feel most of you, though, have already been through this journey of heartache, of pains, of betrayals, of people just being petty for no reason with you. Okay, sometimes you don't understand what did I do to deserve this negativity and this competitive feeling or people trying to backbite around you. It's not you, it's them. Okay, that's the first message that Spirit wants to give you. But what Spirit also loves is that you are working on yourself. You know, there's never smoke without fire. If, the betrayal that happened has taught you many, many things. It has taught you where you perhaps were also trying to win because of the societal conditionings that you have which do not serve you. Maybe you were trying to engage with low vibrational people. Maybe you were trying to get a win that really doesn't give you a long-term win for yourself. Spirit acknowledges the inner work that you're doing. And if you're not doing it, then that is your first urgent message. You guys need to work on yourself. And whenever the Eight of Pentacles shows up, it talks about real hard work. It's about putting in the long labors. It's about tries and trusted on the craft. If you're working on something, if you're looking for a job, this would require dedication. If you've recently joined a new place, make sure that you're doing everything in your capacity to learn, to upgrade. If you're a student, make sure you're not cutting corners when it comes to your study hours. This woman is hardworking. And do you know why? Because she has a vision. She has a creative thought. She has an idea that is already growing inside her. That this card always talks about healing. I love that after Three of Swords, you have the Ace of Cups. Ace of Cups is that new healed person coming out from all the inner work that you've done. Spirit appreciates the inner work that you've been doing, and this will pay off. You've come a long way when it comes to your emotional security. You've come a long way when it comes to how you see the world and what you bring to the world. Where the cards end here with a Queen of Cups is super positive. If you have been worried about a child, a pet, let me assure you, everything's going to be absolutely fine. If you have been awaiting a romantic offer, the more you come into this divine feminine energy, which talks about attracting partners rather than chasing them, which talks about working on your own craft. You see, if you guys, many of you who have picked this pile are creative people, you're working on some sort of a creative endeavor, please focus on it. Please work on that, because that will bring you, you know, the love that you seek. If it is an external love that you're currently looking for, you're also becoming a more healed person overall. You do not get triggered at, you know, petty things. You've understood that your emotions are your strength and not your weakness. You know, maybe perhaps in the past, your sensitivities used to make you insecure, and you're learning to become this Queen of Swords who's actually an ocean of love, an ocean of warmth. She has a very mother-like energy, but she knows her boundaries well. She knows when not to engage with people who do not serve her, who will only give her, you know, more, you know, the more pains than gains. You know how to draw a boundary. If you feel that, no, that's not me yet, that is where you're going at. That is where you need to focus at. That hard work will pay off wonderfully for you. I also see for many of you, of course, if you're looking for new love, there is somebody new coming your way. Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio could be the strong placements in their chart. You know, for a few of you, I also see earth signs, so there could be a Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn showing up. But remember, guys, whoever's picked this pile, you're being asked to do your inner work, the hard 3D tangible work, the long hours, and it will pay off for you. If you have a dream and you're hoping to, you know, start it, especially a creative project or an endeavor, please go ahead. Please go ahead, but do your homework, do your due diligence. Make sure that you're not cutting corners in any manner. Okay, and in case you're going through a, you know, a past conflict that has been causing you troubles, with, you know, the Cup card showing up here, I feel that resolution will easily happen. Let's say there's a family situation where you're facing a lot of heat, there's a lot of workplace politics going on for you. If you stay diligent to your work, Spirit wants to assure you all of this will be temporary for you, and you would be able to find a peaceful resolution, a win-win situation, and you'll come out on the top, okay? I'm now going to look at some more tarot cards that we have for you here. Wow, we have the Five of Swords twice. And this time we have the Queen of Swords. You know, remain assertive. While it's important to be nurturing, if you don't know how to draw boundaries, if you've not learned from this past lesson, then you're missing out on the wisdom that the Queen of Swords has. Queen of Swords is very good at dealing with these kind of people, because she knows how to, you know, cut the bullshit. She will speak her mind. She will say it in a way that the other person will have no other option but to respect her decision and her way of doing things. Be in your power. Also, be open to new adventures. If the past has hurt you so much that you've become cold, it's very important for you to go on a, you know, some of you may be planning a solo travel. Please go for it. I'm currently in a travel when I'm shooting this. There is no guarantee that what life has, but if you don't take that first step, this guy travels light. Do you see? He has a confidant, which is your spirit. You might have a dog who's close to you. You might have an animal spirit which is close to you. Do you see? There are animals here as well. Connecting to animals would be extremely healing for those of you who speak this pile. And yeah, don't stop yourself from going on new adventures, from traveling, from being free-spirited because you've been hurt in the past. These guys, that is the whole point of, you know, low vibrational people and should not be able to determine where you're going in life, right? You're bigger than that, and spirit wants to remind you that just because something didn't work out in the past, learn from it, be wise. I have a strong air sign, you know, coming out here now. So it's a Libra, especially Libra, Gemini, Aquarius. They're very good at using words, you know, the gift of gab, to put people in their place. There might be a Sagittarius who comes your way and takes you out on a long travel. Go for it. Okay, face your fears. That's a very strong message I want to put out to this guy, pile. Let me look at your, wow, didn't I say, if you're facing some fire, that's going to get resolved. Okay, that's going to get resolved for sure. One second, there's someone at the door. So like I said, you are getting the peaceful resolution that you've been hoping for, that you've been trying to achieve. It is coming for you. Heart chakra healing is strongly recommended for you guys. Rama, Dasa, Sase, Sohang, listening to sleep affirmations when you go to bed, carrying this stone actually will also help you because it protects you from these low vibrational people. Smoky quartz will always, it's alchemy at play, so it will take the negative energy and it'll turn it into something positive. If this reading has helped you and resonated with you so far, please don't forget to subscribe and leave me a comment below. Wow, love this message. Sunshine. The sun is shining on your career and business growth. Fabulous communication in relationships. Right, speak your mind, own your power, don't get cold and detached, go on a new journey, work on yourself, and life is not as hard as you perhaps sometimes feel. I hope this helped you. This was a short, quick reading. I'll see you in the next one. Hello and welcome to those of you who's picked Blue Lace again. Another short reading for you. If you're facing throat chakra issues, either you're unable to express yourself or you tend to get triggered and angry when people talk to you and you lose your power and then later feel bad, Blue Lace again is a wonderful stone for all of you. We're first going to look at the Everyday Witch Tarot and then look at the Oracle and the Mini Tarot, okay? So let's see what's come out for you. Wow, I see the Ten of Pentacles already. Okay, explains why I picked this pile. Now that I'm here, I always tell you guys when I pick a pile for myself. And here we go. Okay, can you guys see all the cards? Yes, you can, right? Perfect. You're bored. You're stuck. You're too much in your mind. And while you have offers, those offers do not make you happy. This guy is really troubled because he's done so much yet nothing is working, right? He feels as if nothing is really working out, especially emotionally, okay? You may be receiving love offers, you may be receiving creative project offers, but it does not feel right. This is not what I'm looking for. That is the emotion that you're in, and that has led to a lot of stress, perhaps a lot of overthinking. What is wrong with me? Now we've reached a place wherein we've started to question ourselves. What is wrong with me? Why can't I find what I'm looking for? You're overthinking, you're overanalyzing, and that is actually making this energy stronger, right? If you keep thinking, why is it not working? Why is it not working? Why is it not working? It's not going to work, right? It's not going to work. Give it a rest. Give it a rest. Four of Swords always talks about chill out, sleep over it. It's okay. Because guess what? Transformation is definitely coming. Some of you have actually already covered this journey, I feel, and you're at this place. You're ready to do away with the old. You're ready to, break out of verbatims, belief systems that have been holding you back. Okay, you're ready to work on yourself. This is a very strong Scorpio energy. This always talks about transformation. This talks about leaving behind the old and ready for the new. And oh my God, the moment you can tap into this, the moment you can get into this energy and work with spirit on this, okay, you will have new opportunities showing up for you. one after the other, one after the other. And let me tell you, it's going to become again overwhelming. I see a strong air sign here. I see Scorpio here. So, you know, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. I see Scorpio, as I said. With these opportunities coming your way, that in itself is going to again scare you. But remember not to go back here. Not to go back here. Right? Because if you can stick your ground, if you can take it one day at a time, everything that you've ever dreamed of, it's coming your way. In fact, better than that, Ten of Pentacles is an overall fulfillment. It's one of my favorite cards of the deck. You know, whether you want money, whether you want success, whether you want respect, whether you want love, whether you want children, whether this card talks about the best of everything. Okay, you can get this. Believe in this dream. Instead of trying to think, why is it not happening? Why do I keep getting these, you know, dumb job offers, stupid people? That's a narrative that you're repeating again and again. While you're even talking about it, while you're acknowledging that to yourself, while you're overthinking that, you keep pulling those kind of people. If you can't really start thinking about what you want, it's rather better to focus somewhere else or sleep it out or allow the universe to step in and help you instead of just keeping yourself stuck in this energy, right? Opportunities are definitely coming your way. If you've gone through some, you know, back-to-back rejections in your workplace, there is a transformation coming. But please understand, this transformation is not external. This is internal. You have to internally believe that I can change where I am. You have to internally believe that I have it in me to turn the story around, and the opportunities will come your way. If you've been waiting for somebody to contact you, by the way, that is also happening. There's been a transformation for someone else as well in your life, and they may reach out and, you know, have a conversation with you, and that'll go well. Okay, that'll go well. That's for a very few percentage of you. Maybe you've given a job offer, they've thought over it. Okay, maybe you weren't good enough then, they've thought over it, there's been a change of heart, and now there is opportunities coming for you. Opportunities are going to come for you. You're trying, you know, you're being asked to focus here. Focus here. Past life regression, I don't know why I feel very strongly to tell you guys. Dig deep into past life regression. If you really want to think so hard about it, if you can't let go of whatever is troubling you, look for reasons that have happened in the past. And perhaps you'll find some answers. Perhaps you'll find some healing. Okay, I'm going to now move towards your additional card messages here. Wow, King of Cups, Page of Cups, Seven of Swords. See, this is a lie, guys. You're telling yourself a lie somewhere. I don't think this is anybody external but yourself. You're lying to yourself, right? You're lying to yourself by maybe saying, I'm just not good enough. I'm not meant for this. I don't know how to do this. Maybe I can't make it happen. Maybe it's just not meant for me. Whatever you have ever dreamt of, it is meant for you. You're lying to yourself. Okay? And you need to call yourself out of that bullshit. Okay? It's a little tough love for you guys, but stop lying to yourself. Okay? I don't think this is an external person lying. Sorry, that was my throat literally went off. I don't think this is an external person lying. This is you to yourself. Right? These scripts that you're telling yourself are lies. Working with your inner child, because I think this comes from childhood. You know, you've been told too many times that you have to have it all figured out. Some of you have that kind of a complex problem as well. You don't always need to know the answers. Just be playful. Just have fun. Just show up and do things that you really, really love and enjoy. Many of you are manifesting a very emotionally available partner, if you're looking for one, by the way, because the Ten of Pentacles talks about an overall rounded success. King of Cups is, of course, somebody who knows what they want in life, who are very available, who are empathetic, whose EQ is their strongest strength, right? Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio could be their strong placements. Again, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn could also be their strong placements. Doesn't matter if they don't have it, it's the energy that they are trying to embody. Or you are perhaps also reaching this place. You know, you're working on your inner child healing. If you're not, start working on your inner child. Make space for your creativity. Do silly things just because you love them. Okay, just because you love them, just do it, and you will get to a better place emotionally, in your career, in your you know, spiritual journey. Stop believing the script. Okay, stop overthinking that you're making it harder than it has to be. Clearly you're making it harder than it has to be, and that transformation has to be internal. I really feel you guys need throat chakra help. You struggle to express love, perhaps. That could be another problem. You struggle to be vulnerable could be another problem, because it almost feels like I'm choking out on my words, which talks like you can't express sometimes what you're feeling, and then that leads to a lot of troubles and overthinking, and you know, it becomes blurry or gray to other people as to did that person mean this or did that person mean that. Okay, in fact, two cards came out for you. Wow. Science and travel. This is crazy synchronicity. I picked this pile. In travel, I am traveling. Long distance communication will open up for your life. Exciting experiences for singles and career abundance for others. Like I said, if you're looking for love, I do see it coming. Look for signs. Ask spirit to give you signs. Ask spirit to talk to you. Work with the universe. You don't have to do this alone. Some of you are trying to work it out all alone. Independence is great, self-sufficiency is great, but to believe that we do not need the help of anybody is a false narrative, and that perhaps is the false narrative that you're giving yourself. Your future positive direction will reveal itself. Any doubts and confusion will soon disappear. I also feel you've started to even doubt your dreams. You know, like I said, you don't believe in your dreams anymore. And that's why I ask spirit to give you signs. You know, tell them, if I see this, if I hear this song, if I... You know, that's those are the kind of games you need to play with spirit to give you the kind of messages that you need. And wow, I just said we all need helpful people. Helpful people are also coming your way, by the way, which is why maybe traveling would be great. You're going to connect with people who will help you work through this for you. Okay, some of you might want to go take a reading. Some of you, as in a tarot reading or some kind of a reading like that. Some of you might want to reach out to communities and people and who are more like you, and then you will find that emotional resonance which perhaps is badly missing in your life right now, which is somewhere, of course, making you feel all the more like nothing's working out for me. Okay, apply to any situation that you're in. I strongly felt this is more emotional, family, but this of course could be career for you. If you are struggling with your career, you know, opportunities, I strongly feel you should do something creative, guys. Because the King of Cups with the Ten of Pentacles talks about giving your creativity a chance. Okay, there are many ways for that to happen. Give your creativity a chance if you're struggling with, you know, creative endeavors. Okay, I hope this helped. If it did, don't forget to subscribe. It was a short reading. I will see you in the next one. Hello, pile 3. In case you're wondering why is the lighting different, it's cause it's shot the next day. I'm traveling. Some of you know who follow me on Instagram. So yours was shot the next day, hence the lighting is different. I have your tarot right here. We have some clarifiers which we look at and a fortune cookie. What is it that you need to know right away? What is the urgent message? First things first, either this has happened or it's currently happening. Apply it as it fits. There are some lies that you have been either telling yourself. Seven of Swords is always for me. Of course, Swords is mental energy. Either somebody has been trying to, you know, mentally manipulate you, or you've been lying to yourself about something, and that is being broken down. The universe is stepping in with the Tower moment, and it's been crashed down. The truth is out, and as difficult as it may have seemed initially, the Tower is always a positive energy. It is a much needed breakthrough. It's a much needed intervention from the divine energy, wherein we are told this is it. You know, it's pretty much like our guide stepping in and saying, you're not listening, so here you go. This is what needs to be done. Okay, this I don't feel energetically is somebody else. It feels more mental to yourself, wherein you have been not listening to yourself about something, or you've been, you know, on purpose cutting some slacks where you don't need to cut slack, not looking at the truth of the matter. You would know where it fits, right? With the Page of Wands as the next energy, clearly there is an idea which is budding. You're excited, you're ready to go ahead. You might have some great adventure plans, some travel plans. Your intuition is calling you guys, okay? This is, of course, not a very reliable energy when it comes to relationships, because wands typically don't really know where they're going. They're just excited. You might also have a fire sign around you, Leo, Sagittarius, Aries, who has many plans, but you don't really know where they are going with it, which is absolutely fine. Page of Wands, as any other page, is asking you to, you know, give it time. Let the energy play out. Let the playfulness be the energy that you're working with, instead of trying to make this very heavy than needed to be, okay? If you have any personal creative ideas, please charge ahead and go with it, work on it, because this would require time, this would require patience. If you have been working on something already, you will start to see in the very, you know, I would say as soon as in the next 72 hours, some sort of an affirmation, you know, some sort of a positive confirmation that whatever you have been working on has started to sprout seeds. Do not scratch the seeds to check where is it going, how much long will it take, because that's the end message always with the Seven of Pentacles. Things are growing. Stay patient with yourself, stay patient with others, and let the Page of Wands energy drive you towards the King of Wands energy, right? It can be how you, again, it, you know, it comes down to, don't fool yourself to start making rose-colored bubbles, because you still, you understand that you're at that page energy, and it would require patience, it would require learning, this would require time for it to nurture and grow. This could be a relationship, a business, you know, something for your career, something for your investments. The truth has clearly been shown to you, or is being shown to you. The universe has given you the much needed breakthrough. Now what are you going to do with it? Of course, lies with you. Wow. We have the King of Wands, the Page of Wands, and the King of Swords. I clearly see here, guys, there's no cups here, if you notice. This is not a time to sell yourself rainbows and castles in the clouds. With the two pages here, again, younger people will be very motivated, very inspired by you right now. You might be able to collaborate with people younger than you as well, which is a positive energy right now. You'll grow into the King of Wands. Right? That is what is in the future if you can remain this patient person. Also, remain analytical, remain wise, learn from what you've gone through. Don't be moody, snappy, don't react on that spur of the moment. Today you feel this, tomorrow you feel that. That is not the King of Swords energy. King of Swords energy is very calculative. You know, they know what to show up as, they know who needs what, and because of that inner knowledge, because of that wisdom, the King of Swords is the guided mentor that perhaps you need right now. There could be strong male figures in your life, or maybe women who have strong masculine energy, apply it as it fits, who would be assisting you in the next phase of your life. Take help, but remember that it is you who's been asked to step into this power, step into this leadership role, and own your life, own the stage. Okay, that was a very crisp understanding of where you are right now. Let me just see before I move into your fortune cookie and your angel guidance, if I see anything else. With the King of Swords and the Seven of Swords, guys, if you are, again, I'm reminding you, if you are selling yourself any kind of a delusional crap, it is going to come down really bad, okay? Take this, tarot is not supposed to make you scared, it's supposed to give you guidance, right? Which is why the message here is, what do you urgently need to know? What do you urgently need to know is that, be real, be practical, be logical, be true to yourself, be true to others. Don't try to fool people around you or yourself. That never works out well. If you are being all of that, and if you know that I have put in the seeds at the right place, the investments will pay off. But if you've put your seeds somewhere where you know, I don't know why I even did that, and in 6 months' time you're going to regret it, then you have an opportunity to take the seat, to take the leadership, and drive your life towards where it needs to go. Okay, moving on to, wow, recovery and declutter. I'm going to read this out to you first, because that's exactly what it's talking about. Declutter your life, let go of correspondence, objects, and people you no longer want. Someone will hurt your feelings. I have the tower here. Like I said, this will, you know, tower sometimes feels great, sometimes doesn't, because it's not as per what you wanted, it's what you needed. Okay. Someone will hurt your feelings and reveal a new side of themselves that you may wish to avoid, which is why, again, brings me back to the King of Swords. If you are in a rational energy, you are able to protect yourself from a lot of drama, right? I sense a drama building up for this pile, and I'm hence letting you know in advance. That is why it's an urgent message. Be real with yourself and with others. That's a very strong message for Amethyst for you. If you're going through some sort of a physical ailment, guys, of course that is going to recover. If you've had certain relationships in your life you know, and this suddenly made me breathless, which hasn't happened since the time I've traveled, which tends to make me feel, listen to your body. It's trying to tell you something. Okay. Also, work with Archangel Raphael, talk to your spirit guides. Do you even take out 5 minutes in a day to have a conversation with them? Or do you just wait for tarot readings to guide you? You know, because this has to come from you. This has to be an internal job, not an external job. I hope I'm able to make sense for you, okay? If there has been, again, recovery and Seven of Pentacles talks about that patience which is needed. If you've invested somewhere and you know that you've done this with, you know, the rational mind and logical thinking, don't let the impatience ruin something which can actually give you strong return of investments, right? This could be money, this could be an educational course that you've signed up in, this could be a relationship. Slow and steady wins the race. That is the message I want to leave you with. If this has resonated, please don't forget to subscribe. It means the world for me. Wish you a wonderful, wonderful weekend. Take care. Bye-bye.